Pour aborder le concept de RSE,
in order
on peut
to approach
par quelques
the
définitions.
CSR concept, I would like to start with a few definitions. CSR means company corporate responsibility, sometimes called societal in French or organization responsibility. Some authors define it as the corporate responsibility versus the various groups it interacts with, and beyond the technical legal obligations and economic obligations. There is also the definition given by the European Commission, which has published extensively on the CSR definition. In the 2011 definition, the European Commission defines it as the responsibility of companies regarding the effects, the impacts they have on society, meaning, first of all, that the legislation must be complied with, this is the minimum, and secondly, that companies collaborate with the other stakeholders regarding the integration of the social, environmental, ethical, and human rights and consumers' concerns. The last definition, the most famous one, is the ISO definition, the International Standards Organization, which published in 2010 the ISO 26000 set of standards, whereby CSR leads to an ethical and transparent behavior, contributing to sustainable development, taking into consideration the stakeholders' expectations, complies with the legislation and the international standards, and finally is also integrated throughout the organization and implemented in the organization's relationships with others. In summary, CSR should lead the company to go beyond the legal obligations. The company cannot be content with complying with the legal obligation. It must do more than that. It also should cooperate with the stakeholders and finally enlarge the objectives to stakes which go beyond the financial stakes, what is called triple bottom line, the idea that the company's responsibility is not limited to its profit, but that there is also responsibility towards human beings or people and a responsibility to preserve the environment, planet. So the triple bottom line is people, planet, profit, meaning that the bottom line on the P&L account is a triple line. Now, the triple bottom line is usually represented this way. The environmental, economic, and social sphere would be compatible. The company could make a profit while preserving the environment and developing all social aspects, culture, quality of life, employees' well-being, etc. So the CSR would be harmonious. And the sustainable environment concept is also represented as something harmonious, which allows to develop the three different spheres jointly. But economists have raised a number of questions because they say that it's easier said than done and that the triple bottom line is not so easily achieved. Now, how do we move from the concept of CSR to action? First question, is corporate social enterprise a win-win strategy? The win-win expression is often used in management handbooks and also speeches delivered by companies based on the idea according to which when a company applies CSR programs, this has positive society impacts and also leads to a number of advantages. Production costs are reduced, energy and resources are saved. The company also has a dynamic of innovation that gives it a leading edge on the market. And finally, the brand image is improved, and therefore the company embarks on a win-win cycle. It makes more profit and it makes people more happy, and it embarks on CSR projects again and again. Except the win-win example is hardly ever questioned on the company level. There are many companies which, through corporate social responsibility, behave in a more responsible way, and on the long run, they gain benefits, improve their brand image, etc. But economists still have expressed reserves regarding the transition from the micro level to the macroeconomic level. When a company chooses the stakeholders it wants to work with on CSR, CSR programs, those stakeholders which will be the recipients of the CSR programs, the poorer or less influential stakeholders will hardly ever be chosen by the company. Companies will give precedence to shareholders, consumers in rich country, and pay little attention to local residents in poor countries, whereas they are the ones who will be endangered by possible negative impacts. There is also what we call the rebound effect. When a company finds a technical progress or contributes to technical progress and reduces its impact in terms of less resources used for unit produced, normally this should lead to a decrease in production costs and should be favorable for both the company and the environment, except that this will lead to lower consumption and therefore the rates will decrease and there will be less money available. And the other way around, the rebound effect will lead to greater consumption. This must be developed by economists, and they are working on the concept. Second question, is CSR universal or relative? I don't want to be too relativistic focused, but CSR for a long time has been considered as a standard notion. It was invented in Western countries. It finds its origin in the United States and in European countries, although the notion is different on both sides of the Atlantic. And the CSR notion is, in a way, a universal notion because it means that each economic organization should feel responsible not only to make profit, but it also should feel responsible towards a number of societal and environmental obligations. But there are several ways that the CSR program is applied in rich countries. There is a huge difference in the way CSR programs are applied in emerging countries or poorer countries. They have very specific historical, cultural, institutional features, whereby the way CSR is applied depends very much on the context. In Africa, the state does not have much power and is often dominated by companies and large corporations, and where civil society is not necessarily sufficiently developed, companies have a lot of room for maneuver, and they imagine CSR in a different way. Small companies in Africa very often think that CSR is not about preserving the environment, but maybe giving drugs for free to the children of one of their employees because the children are sick. So again, the way CSR is applied depends very much on the social and cultural context. In conclusion, I believe that we should have a vision of CSR which is not Western-focused. There is no standard notion for CSR, because if we were to base our reasoning on the standard model, we would consider the capitalistic Western model system as the model, and we know it has its limitations. Therefore, I believe that we still need to work on the best way to apply CSR in local contexts, in different contexts, with civil society emerging progressively with a greater role, and different applications allowing us to see the CSR in a different perspective.